Hi, Internet. Welcome to the GarageTorn YouTube channel. It is Thin Lizzy Thursday. So the way we do things around here for people new to the channel, every week we do a Thin Lizzy song. Some weeks it is fan vote, but some weeks it is randomly chosen by the computer live. So this is one of those weeks where the computer is choosing the song. I have no idea what song I'm getting. You, who are watching the video, know what I'm getting before I do. So we're going to fire up that random number generator and see what Thin Lizzy song, or Black Star Riders, or Phil Lynott Solo, adjacent. We're going to see what we're going to get. So hopefully it's something good. Computer, fire it up. And what am I rooting for? You know what? Rooting for Black Star Riders, just to get them out of the way. All right, let's see what we get. The pressure is on with this one. Oh, man. Whew. So, this week, we are doing something off of Nightlife. We are doing Philomena off Nightlife. Oh, man, I have not felt this much pressure on a Thin Lizzy Thursday since last week. And by that last week, I mean like 5 minutes ago because I'm recording two in advance. So Nightlife. Okay. So Thin Lizzy Thursday confession for y'all. I don't own a physical copy of Nightlife. By the time I started collecting Thin Lizzy albums was also the time that streaming became like a huge thing. And so I have physical copies of all the studio albums except the first two in Nightlife. This is one of the ones I just never got around to buying a record of or buying a CD of. And the reason is, they weren't in any of the stores that I went to. All the other ones, like Fighting and Thunder and Lightning, Chinatown, Renegade, there's just, like, the local record store would just, like, have copies of them. And so just if there was the Thin Lizzy album, I bought it, but there wasn't a copy of Nightlife. And then, you know, could I have ordered one off Amazon? Sure, absolutely could have ordered a copy off of Amazon. Absolutely could have. But the thing is, I can stream it whenever I want on my phone, on the YouTube. So just like it wasn't really essential to get it because I could still listen to it. And I'm like, you know, and because it was one of my least favorite albums in the catalog, I'm like, you know what? I'm not in a rush to get it. I still enjoy a lot of the material off this album, but because I maybe don't own the physical copy, I don't, you know, it's interesting, most of the Thin Lizzy albums I actually listen to streaming nowadays. I don't put on the vinyl or the CD, I just listen to it streaming, and so I'll pull up Thunder and Lightning and Renegade and Black Rose, and I'll just listen to those albums, but Nightlife is like a once every other year kind of listen. This album. So, truthfully, I don't remember what this one sounds like. I remember every time I listen to it, thinking it's very pretty, but also not remembering it to be very catchy either. I think, you know, obviously this is a song about Phil's mother, and she is was a lovely lady by all accounts. I cried when she died, because she just seemed like a genuinely really nice person. And so this is a song that he wrote, you know, for his mother. Oh, yeah, actually, I'm remembering this one now. As I thought about it, I'm remembering the hook. Yeah, this is a good one, one of the better ones off the album. And I do listen to this one on occasion, but not frequently. I think just the entire Nightlife album, I thought it was a step down from Vagabonds of the Western World. I know that is a very hot take in the Lizzy community, but this is a good song, And it's going to be interesting placing it under the microscope. But these are like the pre-biases out the way so that you just know exactly where I'm coming from. Nightlife, I know the album, but I don't know it as well as the other albums because I don't listen to it as much. This is one that I thought I forgot, but then I just thought about the hook in my head like, nope, I do remember this one. Let's dive into it and see what we think this week.
Been the wild, wild rover, sailed all over the sea. But this thing that makes me wonder has made a fool of me. For it took me from my childhood underneath the stars and stripes. And I hear the wind whistling through the wild.
I am feeling like such a fool for even like that brief moment where I'm like, I don't remember what this sounds like. As soon as it clicked in my head, like, oh, come on, how did you forget this one, Greg? So big embarrassment for me, the total egg in my face, because, yeah, this is great. This really is a good one. I think Nightlife, because the album flows really weird. It's a very weird listen from front to back. It's much more mellow and experimental than like a lot of other Lizzie stuff. So like it's a weird, the album has a weird ebb and flow to it. It is good. And I think it's underrated. And I think I'm one of the people underrating it. So like I'm part of the problem. But really great here. The great Celtic lines of the guitar harmonies. Phil really allowing his Irish accent to shine in the vocal. Again, great drum from Brian Downey. Taking a look at these lyrics. I've been a wild, wild rover, sailed all over the sea, but this thing that makes me wonder has made a fool of me, for it took me from my childhood underneath the stars and skies, and I hear the wind whistling through the wild wood, whispering goodbye. And it's home, boys, home. It's home, boys, home. It's home, boys, home when you're far across the foam. So basically just, like, saying that, like, he has this calling to go on this journey and live this rock and roll lifestyle and travel the world, but you're still going to miss your mom is basically what it is. And it's a beautiful sentiment. Phil was a mama's boy in, like, the best way. Not just like, I'm a wimp and my mom controls my life, but just, like, he loved his mom. And it's very, very sweet, and wrote this song for her, and it's just, the real authentic Irish melodies. It's very, very sweet, and just excellent. So very cool.
And if you see my mother, tell her I'm keeping fine. Will you tell her that? If you see my mother, give her all of my love, for she has a heart of gold there, as good as God above. And it's home by town, she's home. Thank you.
So I'm pretty sure I have the exact same experience every time I listen to the song, which is every time I listen to the song, I say to myself, wow, this is a really great song. It's emotional, it's potent, it's catchy. I need to listen to this song more and not just forget it and lump it in with the rest of Nightlife that I don't listen to. And I always just don't go back to it. And that is a huge mistake on my part. And that's not to say that Nightlife doesn't have songs that I listen to. I mean, Still in Love with You. I mean, obviously that one gets the rotation. But damn, this is so great. Greg, listen to this song more. You need to listen to the song more. It needs to be in rotation. I say this every time I listen to it too. For some reason, this one always falls through the cracks for me, and I don't know why. I do not know why, because it is great, and I'm enjoying the hell out of it. Happens every time I listen to it. And then I always... Yeah, I don't know if you have a song like this, where you love a band's catalog, and there's a song that sort of slips through the cracks like this, and then every time you listen to it, oh man, that really is great. How come I don't listen to that one all the time? As I said in the last video, a lot of reactors fake their reactions. This isn't fake. This is me just being embarrassed for my poor taste of not listening to the song more. Lyrically, and if you see my mother, tell her I'm keeping fine. Won't you tell her that I love her, and I'll try and write some time. If you see my mother, give her all my love, for she has a heart of gold there as good as God above. And it's homeboy's home. She's homeboy's home. It's homeboy's home when you're far across the home. I mean, it's very sweet. This is a very sweet song. And then great solo. Just awesome.
If you see my L1, will you tell her I'm keeping fine? Will you tell her that I love her? And I'll try to write sometime.
So the lyric is wrong on this lyric site. And I'll try to write sometime. It says, I'll try and write sometime. Just great use of dynamics there. Really great.
And it's all my time.
Okay, so I definitely don't remember the fade. The ending, I definitely did not remember it, in the slightest. That is a weird place to place a fade, because it's fading right as it sounds like they're reaching the natural conclusion of the ending. So I wonder if the band just, completely fell apart there in the studio, and they faded out before, the take got ruined. Because, I did that for one of my songs, spoiler alert. Let's see, you know what, I will pull that up, because you know what, I don't really plug my music on the channel, and since that is actually relevant, I will go ahead and do that. So I'm going to skip towards the end of the song. This is a song called Tonight, off our first album, and as is often the case with my songs, the music is very cool. Yeah, we'll go a little bit farther back, so you can hear this fade. So when you hear the rhythm change and it looks like the band is about to do something really cool there, it sounds like we're about to do something cool, but then just everything fell apart and went to shit. And that's where the fade goes, because the rest of the take was good. So that's why I wonder if that's what happened there at the end of the piece. And I know there's a number of people who say, like, there's no way that they would fall apart at the end. Bullshit. Even great bands fall apart in the studio sometimes. Like, that happens. It's part of music. It's a thing. And so that is going to be canonically what I assume is that the band just went to shit right at that point. Like, that's where the fade goes. But yeah, this is a freaking phenomenal song. It's a song that, hugely underrated in the catalog. Even like as a guy who likes a lot of deep cuts by the band, this is a deep cut that I underappreciate. And, like, taking the time to analyze it, I think that I'm going to finally make it in the rotation. In the same way that, like, Call the Police was a song I never really loved until Thin Lizzy Thursday. But then, like, really breaking it down, honing it in, that song, which was, like, never even, like, made much of an impression on me, period, entered into my rotation. So this is just, it's going to be in rotation now. It's finally happening after all these years. Permanent rotation for Philomena. You know, just great sentiment, great song, all around excellent. I had no complaints here. But now comes the part where we rank it. Oh boy. So where do I put it? I mean, okay, so even though I'm feeling pretty high on it now, like, I don't like it better than Little Darling or Sweetheart or Are You Ready or... You know what? I think this is a hair better than For Those Who Love to Live. Or is it? I do love Randolph's Tangle. You know what? I'm feeling super hot on this. Just because I've been wrong in the past doesn't mean I need to be wrong today. You know, you don't need to stick to your guns. You need to do what is right. And what is right is saying Philomena is an S-rank song. Like, I don't care if I've been wrong about this song in the past. And I haven't really been wrong. It's just like, I've been neglecting it. Like a boy who neglects his mom and needs to write and call and say, hey, mom, how you doing? I have been neglecting the song about moms. Maybe it's because of just, like, weird family stuff with me, where, like, a song about, like, really, you know, bonding with your mom can be, like, a little bit bittersweet. I had a big falling out with my mom, like a decade ago now. Oh man, I'm getting old. But we had a really big falling out and didn't talk for a few years. And eventually we healed that relationship. For those wondering who was at fault, spoiler alert, wasn't me. I was the one who got the apology. But I know there's a stereotype of young people in their 20s, burning the bridge with their parents, sort of went the opposite, and I will just, not get too into it, but the point is, like, it's still, difficult to listen to the mom songs in some way, the I Love My Mommy songs, because it's, once that connection is broken, even when you put it back together, it's like it's never quite the same. There's always this tinge of sadness to it. And so it's in some way harder for me to appreciate art like this, unfortunately. And even though, like, you know, we talk and things are fine now, it's like nothing has repaired that, and it's very tough to get back to. Maybe that's a little TMI, but, so maybe that could be the reason why the song sometimes, is escaping my subconscious. But it's a great song. It's emotional, it's potent, it's catchy, it's well played. I think it's excellent, and I hope you think it's excellent too. Thank you guys so much for watching. Next week, we're going back to the fan vote. So keep an eye out for that poll. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Hit the like button, you know, all the YouTube things. And I'll see you guys next week for the fan choice reaction. Bye, everyone.